Deputy.
Gramagut, Tian Carla. Tisha, this morning in Lahray in County Galway, three people are in the dock for being accused for defending their own private property. This has come about because of legislation that has been signed in this country in 1997. From what I believe, you were actually a member of government at the time, and our now president signed in legislation that has caused major problems around this country. And remember what I said for defending their own private property. This is what these people are being accused of. Peatlands Councils has been set up for turf cutters, Taoiseach. I have spoke to you when you asked me one night to go to a forum. We cooperated in every part of the way. But sadly, the drive is not there, or the initiative from the state body, the National Parks and Wildlife Service. And instead of trying to solve a problem, what they are doing is trying to make criminals out of people that never, ever have been in trouble in their life. This is not a solution to a problem. All this will do is create bigger problems. And Taoiseach, it is now recognised, not by us, but by the so-called experts, that up to 40% of the science used is completely wrong. There are solutions, Taoiseach, and one of them may be that with the announcement of Bord na Mona having 80,000 hectares, that they are willing, that they, when they are talking about shutting down, that some of that ground could be used to make sure that people's private property, the burden put on it, is alleviated. Taking people to court that never saw a court in their life, Taoiseach, will not solve this problem. But the one thing I will say, and every 6 weeks I do meet the national parks, and I will put my shoulder to the wheel in resolving this whatever way it needs to be resolved. But the one thing we keep hearing, Taoiseach, every day is Europe. Europe.
Thank you.
They might not agree. What I am asking you, Taoiseach, will you use your influence as Taoiseach of this country to go to these, be them technocrats or whatever, in Europe, faceless bureaucrats that are infringing on people's property rights, people that are willing to cooperate, but there is a fear with our civil servants that when you go over, you will be told no.
Thank you.
I am asking you, Taoiseach, do you want to see a resolution to this problem, or do you want to see people like this morning with the danger of ending up in jail? And will you, whatever it takes in Europe, Taoiseach, will you go over and explain that this is a complex problem? Because farmers are being driven off their land. Turf cutters are being driven off their bog.
Thank you, Deputy.
This is in the so-called interest of Europe. This isn't a fair way. There is a resolution to it, Taoiseach. But what I am saying to you, would you also make sure and consider that there may be an option in the likes of Bord na Mona grounds to help resolve the issue?
Taoiseach.
Yes, I spoke to you before about this, Deputy Fitzmaurice, and I spoke to your predecessor in the House here, who had agreed a certain line of action and then decided to renege upon that. I can't comment upon any case that's before the courts, as you're well aware. The law of the land will apply and is determined by members of the judiciary. I would say this to you, that Minister Deanahan worked exceptionally hard to try to bring about a resolution to these kinds of cases. And it's not that people are being driven off the land, as you say. It is that the central feature was that they wanted to be able to continue to cut turf, as their forefathers did, on bogs which are determined to be part of a specific environmental entity. And offers were made, and offers have been accepted for free turf or for compensation for not cutting bogs, and that scheme is still in operation. Unfortunately, not all of the people involved, for their own very personal and sensitive reasons, wanted to comply with the offers that were there. If you say that people are willing to cooperate, I take your point about the longer-term involvement of Bord na Mona in terms of peat cutting. And the offers were there, Deputy Fitzmaurice, for alternative bogs to be made available, either that the people could cut themselves or have cut for them. But it wasn't, because of geography, feasible to do that in many cases, because there wasn't a suitable alternative bog available in the localities, as you are well aware. I'd like to see a resolution to it, Deputy Fitzmaurice. I'm glad to hear you say that you're willing to work towards that. And I think without going near the European personnel at all, a degree of common sense might sort this out for everybody, where they can have access to turf, where they can have access to the compensation fund that's there, because the determination of the environmental specifics of the boglands in question has been set there for quite some time. So I regret that it's gone this far. I can't interfere, will not interfere in anything to do with cases before the courts, but I'd like to see a resolution from everybody's point of view to something like this. And I'd make the point that the boglands in question are not being taken off anybody, nor was there every intention that be so. I note the opening up of the Boora bogs in the Midlands recently, and the tourist capacity of that, and the quality of what they have to offer in terms of explaining to others from around the country or from outside what bogs are about, their history, the important part they played in Ireland over the centuries, and their future from a hospitality and tourism point of view.
Deputy Fitzmaurice.
Taoiseach, first of all, you spoke about Bournemouth and options. Would you go to a rented house if you owned your own house? No, you wouldn't. And that was the option that was there. So it was a non-option, to be very clear on that. Taoiseach, what you have to also understand is that there are 35 more of these complexes coming down the line at the end of next year. Nothing has been resolved. Two of those complexes is all that has been resolved in 17 years. And there are 51 more that nothing has been resolved on them. Taoiseach, I welcome that you would look at the option of the likes of Bournemouth. But the reality of it is, and let's be clear on this, I have spoke to officials time and time again, and the one thing we keep hearing from them is, we don't know what Europe will say. Will they accept it or will they not? Well, let's get one thing straight. The property is private people's property. Either we own our land or we don't. Or does Europe think they own our land as well as we're paying them back for bank debt?
Yeah, yeah.
We have got to get clear on this. Designations has been put,
thank
and I'm
you,
not
Deputy.
Talking solely
Please
about
put
box
your question,
feature.
Thank you.
I am talking about where farmers cannot farm their land. And you are well aware of that, even in your own county in Mayo. Down in Limerick, as you go down to West Cork, there are problems where a farmer in marginal land cannot clean a drain, cannot fence their land.
Sorry, Deputy, we're
so
over
what
time,
can
would you
they
put
do?
Your question? Thank
I
you.
Am asking you, Taoiseach, will you go over to Europe and explain to these people, whoever they may be, that we will not tolerate being bullied like that?
Thank you.
We are willing to work with people, but it should not be up to them. It should be in the spirit of partnership, working together. Not them saying, you have to get off your private property.
Thank you.
Because that won't work.
Yeah, well, the issue here is that... Trumbull rights are a long-standing right in Irish law, as you're well aware, going back many centuries. It's not a case of getting off the bog. It's a case of not cutting turf on it. And if the objective is to have turf available, and most houses don't use just turf for heat anymore, and Bournemouth quality obviously is a higher calorific burning standard than just turf that's cut by conventional means. So in that sense, the people retain the ownership and their turbary rights. There's no question of that being interfered with.
Sorry, would you stay quiet?
The issue is that if they decide to cut turf on an area that has been designated for quite some time now as of a specific environmental entity, if it's about turf being available to them, the scheme that has been in place either for lorries of turf to be delivered, or for, well, so the question is that they want to continue to
cut
turf. Yes, I understand your point. But the fact of the matter is that the boglands in question have been designated in a particular way, and that's the law that happens to be there. So what you're saying is that it's about the opportunity and the right to cut their own turf, as distinct to have turf from another location provide heat for homes, whether that be so. I think that for those who've accepted the scheme, Deputy Fitzmaurice, for those who've accepted the compensation or the opportunity to have turf delivered to them, I think they're happy in that decision. Others have a different point of view, and I do hope that your own influence on this would be able to perhaps bring about a resolution to it. And I know that you've been involved intensely over the last number of years, but I would hope that it could be resolved in everybody's interests.
Thank you. That completes leaders' questions for today.